All right, so I guess since I don't know this again, the genealogy, since I'm here with it all, I've scanned in most of the photos of family members, the mother, the father, the what do you call them, the grandpas, the grandpas, the grandmas, the great grandmas, as many as possible. And so they're all there, and so it's like, well, so I put them on the internet, and they're in a, for the family to, when each one of us plucks off, we'll have our photo there that we can give to the LDS church. Say, hey, here's your photo. But unfortunately, it's not great because I'm looking through and I'm looking at Richard, my grandfather. Now my grandfather, what a nut. So he has the birth name, and so in the puzzle, he has the birth name, and then later on he took the name of his, he used his wife's name momentarily. And I'm almost like, well, why? Why does he try to get her away from the snow name? He's just like, it can't have the snow name. I have to get rid of it. And so a lot of things went on because he had the son named with the R and the S, and he also had the. And there's records there that are incorrect as well. I'm looking at, apparently there was an RS one that croaked it in 1980, and that's incorrect with LDS. And I'm like, well, that's not right. You have the wrong data for my grandfather. First of all, that's not his croak date. He did not die then. So it's incorrect, and I don't know where they're getting this information. So, and then also, he doesn't have birth certificate because they burned the courthouse down, and so we have to go through all kinds of hoops to get him in there, to get him actually into the registration process that he even existed. So I'm not really sure how that's going to happen, because we become a missing link, or a missing loop in the whole saga, So why did the question I'm curious right now is, why did he change the name so drastically? Was he chased? Was he chased by creditors? Did he have that as a reason? What was his reason for changing the name? Was he I know they had the mills down there. They had the lumber mills, and he lost the lumber mills. So, but what was the reason that he would change his name at that same time also? Changing it off. Something to do with America, something to do with immigration, possibly. Possibly he was not really truly naturalized. He possibly was a sneak in, An illegal, he could have been an illegal. And so by using his son's, he could have gone with this and used this his own son's, the son who died. He had a son who died when he was like 3 years old. So he could have used his own son's birth certificate as his life event, you know what I mean? He could have used that. And so it just becomes like my grandfather, I don't know what to do about him. And that border crossing, just didn't go well for him. So I have a feeling his name changed drastically at that moment when he became American all the time, when he left Mexico. So yeah, so he could have definitely done that. Used his own son, who had died when he was 3 years old. He used his own son, his birth certificate data, as a life. So now, for any of these, what do you call that, methodical have to government papers, he would have had to use something. So yeah, it's possible that's what happened to Grandpa. So, we are in such a mess. We're such a mess with it, aren't we? Okay, so going back to Mary Wren, going back to Richard Snow, because they are just absolutely delinquents with poetry, with Indians, very possibly simply just an Indian name. Instead of Mary Williams, it would be Mary Wren, because they're birders. They're birders. They just love birds. So it would have been Mary Wren, you know, as a flighty name just given to her, her Indian name. So we'll use Mary Wren as her Indian name and nickname. And then back to Snow. He was born on a snowy day. We all know this. So that's another Indian lore nickname. So all of that, you know. So I know that confuses the actual true Snows, and it confuses the true Wrens. But, yeah. So anyway, I did see some pictures of the lumber mills, and gee, you know, it's after all of this, I'm like, gosh, and that was just like, I don't know, an unfortunate way to wealth that they had at the time, you know, and I'm like, well, why did they have to even have a way to wealth, you know? It was all taken away anyway by stupidity and poker or whatever they were playing. Gambling. Why would they bother, you know, destroy an entire forest and then just gamble it away? I don't know. It's tough. Yeah, history is tough. Yeah. Any hoot. What was I doing? I made baking soda overloaded cookies today, so I guess that's a warning. Don't use too much baking soda. What's the else? Yeah, I mean, gosh dang it. Maybe it's just me. I'm just not used to it, and so it just hits me like extra. I'm taking a break off my coloring book women. I have to because they they wear on my eyesight after a while, you know. I have to give my eyes something else. I did have that as an idea for people, you know. You can do that, you know, for Christmas. You know, upload, you know, the genealogy photos. That's kind of a gift that you can give to every member of your family, and, you know, it's just kind of like, great, you don't have to do it. You know, you don't have to do it, and that can be like a share deal. You can have a private share link through the Google that works, or you can, I don't know, just be completely blatantly open. But I don't think that's fair. I don't think that's fair to everybody. I prefer to just be a private share link. So what else? I don't know. It's raining. Okay, and I guess there was the Miss America deal. That was a good thing. I'm kind of bummed out, actually. I'm kind of depressed today. Because it's just like the world of the, what are you going to do? And that's all I've done, you know, that's all I've done for years, is tell you all of these ideas. That's all I've done.